Hi, my name is Stanisław Frejdak. I am 7th dan from Poland. In this short series of videos, I want to explain how to count values of moves in the endgame. The good news is that everyone can learn it. So it doesn't matter if you're a double-digit queue or a high dan player, this lesson is for you. So here we have two very basic examples. What is the value of taking this stone by black? After he took a stone, he has 2 points. And then, if white played instead, black has 0 points. So, we usually say that taking the stone is worth 2 points. And this is the formula we use. A value of move equals to a difference in a local amount of points between a situation where black played first and a situation where white played first. Here it is 2, here it is 0, so it's 2 points. And then, here we have a similar example. After white plays, this is the final result. And then, if black plays first, this is the final result. So black gets this 1 point and white doesn't get this point. So a difference is 2 points again. So Hane connecting is worth 2 points. And then let's move to a bit more complicated example. If black blocks here, it's clear. Black has 1, 2, and 3 points. But what happens after white plays first? We need to find a way to determine how many points black has right now. So how to think of this position? This position has 3 possible states. The first one, this would be our first stage, is after white connects a stone. Then black has 0 points. Then this is the second one. We need to determine how many points black has right now. And then the third stage is after black takes a stone. Then black has 2 points. So what can we conclude? How many points does black have right now? If white connects, it is 0. If black takes, it is 2. So now we say it is 1 point. It's a mean value of these two. And then we can answer our question. After blocking, black had 3 points. After white pushing, black has only 1 point. So this move is worth 2 points. And here I want to talk about one nuance. So there are people who would disagree with our method and they would say, if right now black has 1 point here, and after taking he has 2 points, then why don't we say that taking the stone is worth 2 minus 1, 1 point. So instead of 2 minus 0, 2 points, they would say it is 2 minus 1, 1 point. So they are using a different formula. This is this formula. They would say that a value of move is a difference between a situation after a move and before a move. And what's interesting about this approach? With this approach, you would just get the same result as with the previous approach, but divided by 2. So we can take one approach, we can take the other, but then we need to be consistent. And this is why I talk about it, because sometimes we would confuse them and we would subconsciously use one of the approaches in a calculation performed with the other one. So we need to know what is the difference between them. And for now, let's remember this one, that the value of move is a difference between local amount of points after black's move and after white's move. Okay, and now we can move to a bit more complicated situation. But first, maybe let's look at this one once more, because there is a useful way to think of that formula. We can divide the process into 2. So first, we will think what happens after white plays and black answers. So with this move, white already gained 1 point. And then how to count a whole value of this move? So then we need to include also the continuation. So we include half of it. We already talked about it, that there are these 2 possibilities. So basically, this connection being worth 2 points, we need to divide by 2. So this would be our new formula, that a value of move is the number of points gained with the first move. So here white already gained 1 point, plus the value of the continuation, which is 2 points, divided by 2. So here we are doing basically the same which we were doing with the previous formula, but it is more useful And we will see it in more complicated examples that this one is just better to use. But here, how is it? Here it is just 1 point, which is the push, plus 2 points divided by 2 equals to 2 points. So the result is the same. And then, having this formula in mind, we can take a look at this more complicated situation. So what happens here? It could be confusing to talk about how many points black has right now and how many points black has right now, but the new formula tells us to first look at this move after white responding and this move after black responding. So what is the difference between these two situations? Here, black has this stone captured and this 1 point of territory. So there is a 3 points difference between this situation and this one. Okay, so this is plus three, this move. And then we need to look at the continuations. So how worthy is White's continuation? If White connects, then he takes these 4 points which Black could get. So this move is worth 4 points. And then what is the Black's continuation? If White doesn't answer, then Black can take these 2 stones and this 1 point of territory. So this one is plus 5 points. And now we can conclude how valuable was the first move. Taking 1 stone itself was 3 points, and then the continuations were 5 points for Black, 4 points for White. So in total, it is 3 points plus 5 plus 4 divided by 2, because these are continuations. So 9 divided by 2 equals to 4.5. And in total, it equals to 7.5. This is the value of playing here. Okay, thank you for listening to the first part of this series.